Okay, welcome to Farmbook again. So today we're having a look at cauliflower. What's the different type of things that you need to look at when selecting varieties, your market, and time of year, things like that. So we're having a look at when we visited Sakata's field day recently and what the different types of varieties are. So here it is.
Okay, please feel free to stop me if I'm talking too fast or you've got questions to ask, and if I can't answer, Jan deals with brassicas a lot. He works in the Cape also. He does a lot of our development work there. So please feel free to put up your hand and stop me. I will not be offended. Okay, I'm quickly just going to run through the cultivars as we walk through. We'll start with the cauliflowers. We all know the cauliflowers, you know, cauliflower picked up recently because we had that whole banting thing, and there's cauliflower rice and cauliflower pancakes and all that stuff. Only tried it once, it wasn't that great, so I still like to eat it the old-fashioned way with cheese and sauce. Okay, so this is one of our new summer cultivars. It's very fast. Okay, so you cannot leave it to stand. Okay, let me just quickly start here. If you look around the field, you'll see that there was three different planting dates. We struggled a lot with the days to maturity with the brassicas. We always do. You'll see that the stuff started flowering there. The heads were ready. You'll see that the cauliflower start opening up here. If you look at this cauliflower, this is a classic example of something that should have been harvested a long time ago. They start turning purple, they become brown because they're exposed to the sun. They lose their wrapping. Okay, so it's very important for us to find a cultivar that's got good wrapping in that specific season. So 10032 was one of our new cultivars that we started looking at. Excellent wrapping in summer, and it's got a very, very... It just starts wrapping
There you can see. So it starts wrapping very quickly
against the sun, and then it matures a bit faster. Okay, so you shouldn't leave it to stand in the field because then it loses its white, beautiful punnet shape. This is what you want for a punnet. You want it to be dome shaped. You want it to sit right in the punnet and be covered up. Okay, that's also something specifically that we're looking for. Obviously, there's people that process cauliflowers. They plant something like some of our opposition varieties, like Corlane, which is not necessarily a perfect dome shape, but it's good for a processor because they can cut it up. They only use the stem, so they only use the bracket like that. They don't care what it looks like as a whole. Okay. Moving on to Merton. Merton is one of our new summer varieties. It's an excellent variety. A little bit faster to mature also, but this is a perfect punnet shape. If you look at this, this is what you would go into the supermarket and buy. It's a nice, I mean, you're a wife, you can tell us, would you go into the market and buy this? Yeah. It's white on the head, and there's no riciness. Do you guys plant cauliflower? Any of you? Okay, that's why there's so many questions here, right? But if you plant a cauliflower and it's out of slot, that's why I didn't harvest some of this stuff, because I didn't want to give you a bad taste of it, but it becomes what we call furry, or it gets a bit of a riciness, okay? And then when you look at it, you can walk through some of the cultivars and you'll see if they're planted out of slot, if they're actually a winter variety and they're planted in summer, they don't like the temperature fluctuation, they get riciness on the head. We specifically look for varieties that doesn't get riciness in that specific slot. So Merton is our answer for a summer variety. Excellent wrapping, smaller shaped plant, and really just a good overall summer variety. Okay, Jan, do you have anything to say about Merton?
No, it's a very good, I think it's an all year round variety, which is nice, because most of the varieties you either can plant in the summer or in the winter. And I found that you can plant the Merton all year round, which is very nice.
Definitely.
It's very adaptable. Yeah.
Very versatile. Okay, so this, you will see our brilliant display of winter broccolis, of cauliflowers here. We didn't put any heads here because this is a classic example of where you'll see the riciness. If you come into the field and you see the yellowing here, and do you see that fine ricing there? Do you see it? It looks like there's like little things protruding from the head. That's riciness. And that means that the variety is planted out of slot. Okay. Usually this is our excellent winter variety. It's called Incline, and it's got a very, very large leaf structure. Okay. It's usually a bit slower also. If it's got such a big leaf structure, what we tend to see is that it sits its heads deeper into the plant, and it takes a bit longer to mature.
Does it use more nitrogen because it's got more leaves?
Well, because it's in the field longer, you will have to apply fertilizer for longer.
Ah, okay. Makes sense.
Because in winter, everything is slower. We are also slow as humans, so we can't blame the plants.
So yes, we are a bit slower as humans in the winter time. But yes, just accentuates again your selection of varieties and how important it is specifically for your market, and all the different type of things you need to look at. So if you're interested, get in contact with your local Silicata agent and they will assist you. Till next time, cheers.